look around at yourselves and look at the beauty of Mother Africa, because the beauty of Mother Africa is in her people. The suffering of Mother Africa is in the suffering of her people. We come from different walks of life tonight to be here. And this reverential evening is to pay tribute to our ancestors, but it's also to pay tribute to ourselves, because we are the embodiment of our ancestors. And just like Osibaremba shared with us, we honor ourselves and we honor our ancestors. And wherever it is that we gather, we should always remember them, because they are us and we are them. So let's celebrate tonight as we hold this evening reverential. When this idea and concept was established over 2 decades ago, it was said that we were celebrating Panifest, and then when Emancipation Day was introduced into the Panifest celebration, we said when we celebrate emancipation on August 1st, it's a celebration. But we can't celebrate until we remember the struggle of our ancestors and those who allowed us to be here by their struggle. So let's give a round of applause, not because a round of applause, but because we want to make noise for the ancestors tonight with our clapping of hands, to let them know that we appreciate them. They are our heroes. They are our heroines. Without those strong African men and women who were determined to be free, we wouldn't be here, not only in our physical form. I'm not talking about we wouldn't be in existence in a body, but we wouldn't be here with our free mind, with our mind to resist, with our mind to defy, with our mind to conquer, with our mind to be victorious in our African self and our African being. You didn't think with a conscious mind without that mind coming from somewhere. You didn't think to be free and be defiant without having come from somewhere. And it comes from our ancestors. It comes from those who went before us. Over 100 years ago, the Honorable Marcus Mosiah Garvey was at the height of his movement in 1921. We're 100 years later. Marcus Garvey wasn't allowed to step foot on this continent. But look where you are, those who traveled across that Atlantic. You're in Africa. You're in Ghana. Don't take that for granted. He gave his life to plant an idea, and you and I are that idea. We're the living embodiment of that aspiration. And that roll call can be many more names besides Marcus Garvey. Names that we won't remember. Names that are not in anybody's history book. Names that people have forgotten, but they laid their lives down so we can proudly get on an airplane or a boat, whatever way you travel here, and come to Mother Africa and walk on this sacred soil and say, not only is Africa sacred, but African people are sacred. The whole world is looking at Mother Africa and the resources of Mother Africa, but they want to neglect the African. But no Africa without the African. No African land without the African people. So, one of the principles of Panifest was established on was to tell the truth about the history of African people. And that's why we've set this space and time. That we come together through all the days of Panifest, through our colloquium, through our rituals, through our programs, was to see each other, to commune with each other, to interact with one another, and to take advantage of the forum and the platform that has been set that we get to know this African family all over again. So let's express love this evening, let's share love this evening, let's appreciate the evening, and continue to give honor to our ancestors. Ashe, amen. Freedom, freedom, freedom. Free means to liberate, dome means the mind. Freedom means liberate the mind.
Thank you very much, thank you very much. I told you it's the light of the place. Thank you, Rabbi.